Today, I'm going to show you how you can use AI to create a presentation, website, social media site, and even a document easily with just a simple prompt. We're going to demonstrate it on a software called Gamma. Now, this one is an interesting tool, and I'm just going to jump straight in. Now, as you can see here, it gives you a few different options. So the first of these options is that you can paste in some text. Now, this could be a ream of text from study or whatever you're doing, research, maybe even trying to prepare for a meeting in advance. And you can also import a file or URL. Now, you can choose from a range of different files, including PowerPoints that you've already got, Drive, or import from a URL, which could be a website as well. Now, there is this option, Generate. And from here, you can create a multitude of different formats. The first format is presentation, and then web page, document, and social. And that will create different formats for you to get started on. So as you can see, the first format, you can change up to 10 cards for the free plan. And then you can see here that you get 10 cards as well, with sections for the website as well. Same with documents and same with social media as well. So you can choose a range of different prompts, but I've got one here pre-created for the presentation. So as you can see, the outline is quite clear. I want a sushi shop, I want to sell it, and I want to emphasize the opportunities to grow it. So I'm going to go ahead and generate that outline. So as you can see here, it's spouted out a bunch of text, some basic templates for me to start building on and refining. And the idea is to help get that element of building the structure out first. So I'm going to go down here, and you can see there are a few different themes here. I can choose some from one of the basic ones or go into more detail as well, including, I guess, making it a bit more your theme. Once you've selected a theme, you can choose the amount of text per card, and you can choose the source of images as well. So for example, if I wanted to be fun and cool, I could choose animated GIFs, and then I'm going to go ahead and generate. So as you can see, it is generating in the background here, but what is different about this is that it took me 400 credits to generate this, and it will tell you down in the bottom left hand corner every time you do a generation. Now, you get a limit of how many generations you can do as part of the free plan. You get 600 credits as part of the free plan, but you can upgrade for unlimited access, which means you get, of course, unlimited all you want. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Zapier. If you're interested in those guys, you can check them out in the link in the description. So first things first, you can edit this and refine this. So you can go up here and change the theme to something that you find a bit more suiting to your style and feel. Now, as you can see, this is more of a template. So it's not got the name right. It's not got the facts right, the details as well. Well, it's got partial facts right, but it's not got the entire feel and the generation that I want. So I can go over here and use some of these card templates to basically replace information. So for example, if I wanted to add in a timeline, this is a pre-created timeline that I've got made. I can also add images, basic blocks as well, like toggles and other stuff, charts and diagrams, which might help me to emphasize the finances, forms and buttons as well, if I even wanted to send this to a client and then be able to book a meeting with me using Calendly, or maybe even a tally form if they wanted to carry on the process. Now up here, there's a presentation mode, and this basically turns everything that you've created into a simple visual. And that's great for just jumping into meetings and starting to work on them. And now I can see that I can go and overview all of the information. Now, this is going to get you 60% of the way there. The rest of the 40% is obviously refining and making it that perfect experience. What's nice about this is taking the administrative layer out of the work. Not all of the administrative layer, but just that element of it. And you can see here, there's even some funny demonstrations they brought in of the expertise behind the sushi and investment opportunities as well. And that's the bottom of the page. So I can share this if I want to. I can even export this into a PDF or a PowerPoint to go even further. I can turn it into a Google Slides and export the PNGs as well. I can also embed it if I wanted to share it on the website and be able to share collaboration access as well. So there is a feature that is dedicated to premium users, and it's called Ask AI 2, and you can basically refine down whatever you've created so far. So you could say on the expertise slide, make sure to remove this person and replace it with this. But with this one, you need the enhanced AI structure, and that is as part of the Plus and Pro plans, which give you access to unlimited AI generation and better quality images and cards as part of different models. So here is a demonstration of the document being generated. And as you can see, I've basically set it up so that it only does two cards worth of content. And as you can see, it started to pull out the general outline of the feature. This is more structured towards a document, so you can refine this and make it a little bit more attractive, but a good way to get started and building out what you may want to change out. So the one thing that you may want to do is obviously refine this a lot more so. So you can obviously go into this document, changing some of the information and editing the using AI. So for example, you could condense text or reword it based on the information that you've provided. But the benefit to this is you can leave comments for other people, or even allow other people who've been invited access to leave comments as well. So a very helpful way to do that. So one of the things you can do in the documents area is you can modify the background image and card styling, as well as whether it's full bleed or not, and how the content aligns as well. You can also change how the card width is structured too. So one of the last things we're going to do is generate a website. And as you can see, I've got a prompt here for that. Now, one of the things that I would recommend as a tip is to take your prompt that you've got, run it through ChatGPT, and narrow down what the prompt is for the exact situation. So I changed the prompt based on the format that it has. And obviously, I'm going to get a better generation of output. So here we go. I maybe want this one to be a little bit more detailed. And you can see that I can choose an image model as part of this one, because obviously it is a web-based one. So it's going to be pulling in more images that demonstrate in the background and things like that. So this is what the live website looks like. And let's be fair, it's not going to blow you away, but it is going to create the basic structure that you want for a website. And for a business that may not worry too much for website design, this could be a good starting point. So this is what that website looks like on mobile device. So it's something that allows you to easily do it through. So the website is mobile responsive, as you can see on the screen now, which is a great bonus of part of creating through Gamma. So those were a few demonstrations of how to use the AI to create a website, to demonstrate a presentation and bring together a document. Now you can see here that I used quite a fair amount of credits in that process, but you can get unlimited credits by unlocking or referring a friend, which means you get 200 credits and they get 200 credits. You can also invite a team member too, which applies the same concept. So again, very simple in terms of setup. You can modify things like what AI image model they are used in settings and really refine it. But a great way to use AI for presentations and light websites. Again, it's not going to do everything for you, but it is going to get you a step closer. So if you're interested in more AI news and resources, you can jump over to the Shortcut AI, which is our newsletter to help you keep updated with the world of AI. You can find that linked below if you're interested. Thank you very much, folks. If you're interested, do subscribe, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio for now.